Hi friends, once again welcome to my channel Accounting to Maths by Balaji. So till now we studied two chapters of arithmetic. First one is percentage chapter, is about 19 classes, and second one ratio and proportion is about 26 classes. So today we are going to look a new chapter, that is third chapter, profit and loss. Okay, that is part one of profit and loss. Let's start our class now. Yes, part one of profit and loss. Key terms: cost price, that is also known as investment, konna vela. Simply we read it as CP. Second, selling price, ammina vela, dani manamo simple ga SP ani antam. Profit or gain, telugulo labham, it is denoted by P or G. Loss, nashtam, it is denoted by simply small l. Let us see the profit story. What is that? Profit story. What is profit story? Suppose we invest rupees 500 on a shirt. To make a shirt, we invest rupee 500. And We sold it for rupee 700 rupees. We sold it for 700 rupee. Since in this case, SP is more than CP. Since SP is greater than CP, in this case, we get a profit. In this case, we made a profit. Profit is equal to how much? 200 rupees. Profit is 200 rupees. Yes, when we get profit, if SP is greater than cost price, then we get profit. And that profit is equal to difference of selling price and cost price. That is profit equal to SP minus CP. Manaku ammina vela kante konna vela takku unnappudu, leda konna vela kante ammina vela ekku unnappudu labham vastundi. Aa labhamu deniki samanam ante ammina vela minus labham vastundi. Labham equals ammina vela minus konna vela. Ammina vela minus konna vela. Yes, manamu invest chesindi konna vela 500 rupayalu, ammina vela 700 rupayalu. Davati yokka tedane labham 200 rupayalu. Right. So profit percentage equal to profit or loss always calculated on cost price. Labham gani, nashtam gani, ellapudu kuda konna vela pai lekkinchabadutundi. Ellapudu kuda konna vela pai lekkinchabadutundi. Okay, yes. Profit percentage equal profit by CP into 100%. Mana percentage lo kavali 100%. That equal, what is profit? Profit equal to SP minus CP. So selling price minus cost price by cost price into 100% is equal to profit percent. Labha shatam equal labham by konna vela into 100 shatam. Kani labham equal manaku telusu ammina vela minus konna vela. So labham badalu ammina vela minus konna vela by konna vela into 100%. This is formula. Yes, what is the profit percentage here? Profit is 200. Therefore, profit percent equal profit 200 by cost price 500 into 100%. Two zeros cut. Five ones, 520 is 100. 220s are, yes, 40% profit. Yes, profit percentage equal to what? That is
40%. We made a 40% profit here. Now, let us see profit percentage by ratio method. That is very, very important method. Profit percentage by ratio method. Profit percentage by ratio method. Actual process is lengthy process, so we will discuss a shortcut method, that is percentage, profit percentage by ratio method. Let us consider ratio of cost price to selling price, that is 500:700, which is equal to 2 zeros, 2 zeros cut, 5:7. The ratio of cost price to selling price is 5:7. Yes, selling price is 2 units more than cost price. Selling price is 2 units more than cost price. So, we made a profit here. Therefore, profit percentage equal profit is 2 units. Profit percentage always calculated on CP. So, CP is 5 units. We know that 1 by 5 fraction value is 20%. Then, twice the 1 by 5 is 2 by 5. So, here also do the same operation. Twice of 20% is 40%. So, profit percentage equal what? 40%. Profit percentage equal what? 40%. This is the golden method to find profit percent or loss percent in shortcut way. That is called ratio method. Okay. Let us see. This is the story of profit. Now, loss story. When we get loss actually, let us suppose our investment is ₹500. Our investment is 500 and we sold it and selling price is ₹400. CP is greater than SP. Yes, here CP is greater than SP. That implies we get loss. We get loss. And the loss is how much? Loss is 100 rupees. Loss equal what? 100 rupees. Okay. That is, loss is difference of CP and SP. Difference of CP and SP. Therefore, loss formula is given by CP minus SP. Nashtam. Loss anaga nashtam equal. Konnavela minus Amminavela. Chudandi, what is the loss? Loss is 500 minus 400. That equal what? 100 rupees. Yes. So, loss percentage. Next, we have to find loss percentage. Loss or profit is always calculated on with base CP, cost price. So, loss percentage equal loss by CP into 100%. But loss is given by CP minus SP by CP into 100%. So, loss percentage equal loss is 100 rupees over CP is 500 into 100%. 2 zeros, 2 zeros cut. 5 ones, 5 20s. So, loss is 20%. Loss percent is 20%. Let us see it by loss percentage by ratio method. By ratio method. We always use this method to find loss percent as gain percent. So, ratio of CP to SP is 500:400, that is 5:4. SP is 1 unit less than the SP is SP is 1 unit less than the CP. So we get loss. Loss is always calculated on with base CP. That is 1 by 5 percentage value is 20%. So negative symbol denotes loss. 20% loss. Okay. We will use always ratio method to find profit percent or loss percent. Okay. Profit is equal to what? Selling price minus cost price. From this, we can get another formula. That is CP equal selling price minus profit, or selling price equal cost price plus profit. And also, loss is given by cost price minus selling price, which is equal. From this, we can get another two formulas. CP equal SP plus loss, or SP equal CP minus loss. Okay, these are the important formulas. Next important concept we will use these concept in questions, while doing questions. So listen carefully. Suppose we are given 16 whole 2/3% profit. Suppose we get 16 whole 2/3% profit. Then find CP is SP equal how much? Cost price to selling price ratio is how much? Since we know that loss or profit are always calculated on, cost price, or always calculated on cost price. Yes, what is the fraction value of 16 whole 2/3%? 16 whole 2/3% fraction value is 1/6. It is given the profit, so you write positive fraction. You write positive fraction. Plus symbol denotes that is profit. That is 6 times of 16 whole 2/3% is 1. 6 times of 16 whole 2/3% is 1. Since loss and profit always calculated on CP, the base value denotes as this is CP. So if CP is 6 units, then profit is 1 unit. CP is 6 units, then profit is 1 unit. Therefore, we have to find ratio of cost price to selling price. Yes. CP is 6 units, then selling price is given by, when profit we made, selling price equal cost price plus profit, 6 plus 1, 7 units. Okay. This is very important. Suppose we are given 22.22% loss. 22.22% loss. Yes, we know that 22.22% fraction value is equal to, that is 2 by 9. Since 11.11% fraction value is 1 by 9. So 2 times of 11.11 is 22.22. Here also we do 2 times of 1 by 9. That is 2 by 9. Yes. But loss or profit always calculated on CP. So denominator shows us CP is 9 units. Since it is loss, we denote it as negative symbol, negative fraction. So 9 units are CP, then we get 2 units are loss. Since 9 times of 22.22% value, 9 times of 22.22% value is 2 units. So loss is 2 units. So CP is SP is equal to CP is 9 units. When we incur the loss, SP is given by CP minus loss, 9 minus 2, that is 7 units. Okay, this is what the concept where we use in questions. Okay, next let us see another one. For example, we got 35% profit, then find CP is SP. CP is SP. Since we know that 5% fraction value is 1 by 20, 35 is 7 times of 5%, so that is 7 by 20. That means 35% fraction value is 7 by 20. And it is given profit, so we use plus symbol, that is plus fraction. Since loss or profit always calculated on CP, so 20 units are CP, then 20 times of 35% is 7. 7 is profit. What is the ratio of CP to SP here? CP is 20 and we got profit. So in this case, SP is given by CP plus profit, 27. Okay. Next, let us see another concept. Next concept. Scaling factor. Scaling factor method. Scaling factor method. CP, profit or loss, SP. Suppose CP of analytical is X rupees. CP of analytical is X rupees and we get 13% profit. Unsold the article, we got 13% profit. 13% can be written as 0.13. 13% means in decimal notation it is 0.13. Then what is SP? SP is given by CP plus profit. CP is X rupees plus profit is 0.13 times of X. 0.13 times of X. Since profit or loss always calculated on CP. Then what is the SP? Take away the common term, 1 plus 0.13. That is 1.13 times of X. Yes, this 1.13 is called scaling factor. It is called scaling factor. Suppose the cost price of analytical is Y rupees and we get 23% profit on the article. Then 23% can be written as 0.23. in decimal notation. Then what is SP? SP is given by, since profit is given, SP equal CP plus profit. CP is Y rupees and profit is Y times of 0.23. Since profit always calculated on CP, that equals Y times of 1 plus 0.23, that is Y into 1.23. So here 1.23 is called scaling factor. So if CP is Y and there is a 23% profit, then SP is 1.23 times of CP. Then SP is 1.23 times of CP. Suppose next example, let us see next example. Suppose cost price of an article is Z rupees. Cost price of an article is Z rupees and we incurred a 24% loss. We incurred 24% loss. So loss is denoted by the symbol negative. This can be written as minus 0.24. Yes, 24% decimal notation is 0.24. So what is SP in this case? SP, when we get incurred loss, then SP is CP minus loss. When we incurred loss, SP is given by CP minus loss. Yes. CP is Z rupees minus loss is, since loss or gain always calculated on cost price. So 0.24 times of Z. That is, take it out with a common term Z, 1 minus 0.24. So that is Z times of 0.676 times of Z. If cost price of an article is Z and if we incurred 24% loss, then SP is 0.76 times of cost price. Then SP is 0.76 times of cost price. Okay.
By using all these concepts, let us see example problems.
Yes. First question, Rakesh bought an article at rupees 400 and sold it at rupees 600. Then find his profit or loss percentage. Rakesh oka vastuvunu rupayalu 400 konni rupayalu 600 ammadu. Aina athaniki labham ledha nashta shatham enta? Athani labham ledha nashta shatham enta? Yes. Since SP is greater than CP, అమ్మిన వేళ కొన్న వేళ కంటే ఎక్కువ కాబట్టి అతనికి వచ్చేది ఖచ్చితంగా లాభమే వస్తుంది. సో హీ గాట్ ఓన్లీ ప్రాఫిట్ బట్ నాట్ లాస్. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ ప్రాఫిట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బై ద ఫార్ములా ఎస్పి మైనస్ సిపి, దట్ ఈక్వల్ ఎస్పి 600 మైనస్ సిపి ఈస్ 400 విచ్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 200 రూపీస్. ఎస్ వై టు ఫైండ్ ప్రాఫిట్ పర్సంటేజ్ అండ్ వీ నో దట్ profit percentage equal profit by CP into 100%. That is 200 by CP is 400 into 100%. Two zeros cut, four ones are 450s are 200. That is 50%. Yes, profit is 50%. It is actually basic method. We use this method in school mathematics. But whereas competitive field, we use this method, that is ratio method. That is ratio method. Consider the ratio of CP to SP. CP is 400 is to SP is 600. So ratio of these two is 2 2s are 2 3s are. Yes, 2 is to 3. Ratio of CP to SP is 2 is to 3. Since SP is 1 unit more than CP. SP is 1 unit more than CP. So, profit is 1 unit over CP2. That is, half is nothing but 50%. The percentage value of fraction 1 by 2 is 50%. Okay. So, plus symbol denotes that 50% profit. So, answer is C. Okay. Next question. From this question, we will use only ratio method. Right. The ratio of CP and SP of an article is 216 is to 306. Yes, given is it CP is to SP equaled 216 is to 306. The gain percent of an unit. Simply, SP is more than the CP, we get gain. ఒక వస్తువు కొన్న వేల మరియు అమ్మిన వేల నిష్పత్తి 216:360 అయినా ఆ వస్తువుపై లాభ శాతం ఎంత? Since 6 3s are 18, 6 6 are 36, 6 5s are 30, 6 on the 6. Again, 3 12s are 3 1s are 3, 3 7. So, 5 units is profit over CP base is 12 units. Since 1 by 12 value is 8.33%, then 5 by 12 is 5 times of 8.33. That is 5 times of 8.33% is equal to 5 3s are 15, 1 carry, 15 plus 1, 16, 1 carry, 40 plus 1, 41.65%, approximately equal to 41.66%. Okay, so answer is B.
Okay, students, this completes the part 1 of profit and loss. Okay.